Hey, what's up guys? How are you? I know I have been gone for quite some time and I'm really sorry for that. I know no excuses, but I'm really sorry for that. But nonetheless, I have 500 of you watching me now, so yeah, that's a good news. So yes, I'll be making more and more videos on this channel now because I have quite some people of you watching this channel. Anyways, keeping that aside, let's just talk about this thing, shall we? Now, I've been using an old second generation Intel i5 with 16GB RAM and this is the NVIDIA Geforce GT 240, a 1GB DDR3 VRAM to edit my videos and to compose my videos and do all that good things. Until now, there's this something weird happened last night, or rather last week, and my GT 240 broke down on me, meaning time for a new graphics card. Now, getting the GTX 760 or anything higher than that for my second generation i5 along with 16GB of RAM was a little overkill for me, so I wasn't looking for anything beyond say 384 CUDA cores and something that would fit my budget. Considering the fact that I'll be making a new video editing PC and I'll be building that PC sometime very soon on this channel, my budget for this particular graphic card this time on my old PC was something about $100 or 6000 Indian rupees. So for that money and for this PC, I think the GT 70 is the perfect buy. If you are into video editing or video composing and you are using the Adobe Creative Suite to do all these things. So the GT 740 perfectly fits my budget, and in this money I get 384 CUDA cores of shader memory, 128-bit memory interface, 80GB per second memory bandwidth and a DDR5 memory interface with a handy dandy 1GB VRAM for your user applications. Anyways, here are some benchmarks and test results of NVIDIA GeForce GT 740. Now, I am not dealing with 4K out here. I am not shooting in 4K. I am not editing my stuff in 4K. Everything I am doing right now is at most 1080p, and this card and my current PC is pretty much doing well for that 1080p configuration. But I know I need to grow, and I know I need to upgrade my CPU, and I know I need to upgrade my GPU. But for now, this thing is absolutely perfect for my budget. I know people go CUDA hungry whenever they're trying to buy their graphic card for their video editing purposes and for their video compositing purposes. I don't know why they don't realize the fact that a graphics card CUDA cores is not the only thing to consider when you want a graphic card for your video editing purpose. The memory bandwidth interface, the graphics card interface, all these things are equally important when you are looking for a graphic card to suit your absolute video editing needs. I know there are a lot of AMD competitors out there. I know there are a lot of significant cards by AMD, but then if your budget is $100, if your budget is about 6000 to 6200 rupees, if the primary work of your graphic card is to edit and process videos, then this one is probably the best one out there in the market, period.